We are here today outside Cartier in Bond Street to highlight the link between diamond jewellery and Israeli war crimes and human rights abuses being committed today in Palestine. Israel is one of the world's leading producers of cut and polished diamonds. It imports rough diamonds, more than doubles their value by cutting and polishing, and exports them globally via hubs in London, Antwerp, Hong Kong, New York and Mumbai. In 2011, Israel's net export of diamonds was worth $10 billion, 30% of Israel's manufacturing export, Israel's number one industry. 40 to 50% of diamonds purchased in the US in dollar terms are from Israel. Most people don't realize that diamonds sold in jewelers worldwide are bankrolling Israel's war machine. Israeli economist Shir Hera testified at the Russell Tribunal in November 2002 that overall, the Israeli diamond industry contributes about $1 billion annually to the Israeli military and security industries. Every time someone buys a diamond that was exported from Israel, some of that money ends up in the Israeli military. $1 billion every year. That's $2.7 million every single day that diamonds sold at jewelers like Cartier contribute to war crimes against children in Palestine. This summer we saw 521 children slaughtered by Israel whilst they took shelter in UN schools and in their homes. The Kimberley process is supposed to prevent the trade in diamonds that funds human rights violations. But the Kimberley process denies the definition of a conflict diamond, excludes cut and polished diamonds. Jewelers exploit this anomaly and deceitfully claim diamonds crafted in Israel are conflict proof, despite the UN Human Rights Council having found Israel guilty of war crimes and possible crimes against humanity. The Kimberley process needs urgent revision, and at the moment it's simply used to whitewash Israeli blood diamonds and present them falsely as conflict-free and ethical. Diamonds that fund war crimes are not conflict-free and are not ethical. Israeli diamonds bankrolled this summer's genocidal slaughter of Gaza, which left over 2,000 people dead. Shame on the Kimberley process for ignoring Palestinian lives. Diamonds crafted in Israel cannot be distinguished from other diamonds. Unless a diamond is laser inscribed to identify where it was crafted, or the jeweler can provide documentary evidence of where it was cut and polished, there is a high risk that the diamond you are buying is an Israeli blood diamond. The lives the children that diamond has helped kill will forever be on your conscience. Please don't buy Israeli blood diamonds. An engagement ring is meant to signify love, not death and slaughter. Don't wear a trophy of Israeli butchery on your finger. Boycott Israeli blood diamonds!
Boycott Israeli blood diamonds!
Boycott Israeli blood diamonds! Cartier sources its high-end jewelry from Israel's leading diamond exporter, Leo Shatter Diamonds. Leo Shatter Diamonds has received Israeli's Exporter of the Year award, and last year alone accounted for nearly 6% of all Israeli diamond exports, which when extrapolated suggests a contribution of nearly $60 million to the Israeli army through taxation alone. We are here to tell Cartier to stop peddling in Israeli blood diamonds, and so is partnership with Leo Shatter Diamonds. Cartier, stop your trade in blood diamonds! Cartier, stop your trade in Israeli blood diamonds! Shame on you, Cartier!
Shame on you, Cartier!
Shame on you, Cartier!
Shame on you, Cartier!
Free Palestine!
Free Palestine!
My God, Israeli diamonds! They are Gaba and Palestinian blood! My God! Israeli diamonds, they are Gaba and Palestinian blood. Cartier, you are complicit with Israeli war crimes. Cartier!